In the previous lecture, we saw that high voltage windings or windings with greater number of turns and the low voltage windings can be arranged in either concentric or sandwich arrangement. While concentric windings are used in the core type transformers, but sandwich windings are almost exclusively used in shell type transformers. The positioning of the HV and LV windings with respect to the core is also very important from the point of view of installation requirement. Because of easier insulation, concentric windings are placed at the low voltage winding closer to the core, while the sandwich windings are placed on the outside. The insulation spaces between the low voltage and the high voltage coils also serves to facilitate cooling. In this lecture, we'll try to get ourselves familiarized with the different types of windings that are used in the transformer, their using criteria, formation, current and voltage ratings, and their advantage and disadvantage. The concentric winding are of four types, that are spiral winding, helical winding, crossover winding, and continuous disc type winding. Let us see what is spiral winding. The first type of winding that is used in the transformer is spiral winding. It is only suitable for the windings that carry currents more than 100 ampere. Typically, it is employed for LV windings, but it can also serve for HV windings in cases where windings needs to carry a current exceeding 100 ampere. The spiral coils are typically constructed by layers wound continuously from top to the bottom of the coil. The composite conductor of the coil may comprise multiple squares or rectangular strips arranged in parallel. These coils are mechanically strong and typically wound on a former or directly on a solid insulating cylinder. The spiral coils can be wound in a single layer or multi-layer configuration. Small transformers are sometimes wound in multi-layers because it is difficult to arrange the winding satisfactorily in a single layer. When a radial arrangement is necessary, it becomes essential to introduce transposition along the entire length of the winding. The transposition is done to ensure the resistance and the leakage reactance of each conductor remain equal throughout the winding. Helical winding. Helical coils occupy the intermediate range of current capacity, bridging the gap between high current capacity of spiral coils and the low current capacity of multi-conductor disc coils. A helical winding is employed for low voltage coils in medium and high capacity transformer where the number of coils is relatively small, but the current flowing through the winding can be as high as 2000 amperes. The coil is wound helically with each conductor consisting of rectangular strips wound in parallel radially. To ensure the uniform distribution of current along the parallel conductors, they are systematically transposed within the winding so that the conductor occupies every position. The practice promotes load balance, minimizing potential imbalance, and optimizing the efficiency performance of the winding. The number of parallel conductors in a helical winding typically ranges from 6 to 20. The ducts are formed by spacers placed regularly around the periphery of the cylinder. The helical windings incorporate axial spacer placed between the adjacent turns within the winding. The presence of those spacers facilitates better flow of oil within the winding, resulting in more efficient heat dissipation and enhanced overall cooling performance. Helical windings are mainly used in large transformers for low voltage applications 11 kV to 33 kV and power transformers ranging from 150 kVA to 30 MVA at voltage between 400 volt and 11 kV, sometimes up to 33 kV. In general, simple single layer helical coils are used for LV side of the large transformers. However, multi-layer helical coils may be used for high voltage windings. Multi-layer helical winding is commonly used for high voltage ratings, specifically at 110 kV and above. These windings include several cylindrical layers concentrically that are wound and connected in series. The outer layers of these windings are made shorter than the inner layers for distributing the capacitance uniformly. These windings basically improve the surge behavior of the transformers. The crossover winding. The crossover coils are suitable for windings which carry current less than 20 ampere. These are largely used for high voltage windings of comparatively small transformers. These transformers feature numerous turns employing conductors with small circular section which are converted with double layers of cotton or paper insulation. Depending on the voltage rating, the entire winding may be divided into multiple coils. These coils are usually wound on formers. Generally, a coil consists of multiple layers with each layer carrying multiple turns. The conductor can be rounder or rectangular strip. The complete assembly utilizing the crossover coils consists of multiple coils connected in series. This assembly is then positioned over the limb of the core. Insulating key sectors are used to separate the coils and create gaps in between them. These gaps allow for free oil circulation, enabling efficient cooling of the transformers. The axial length of each coil and the separation distance between the coils are adjusted based on the voltage rating of the transformer. Different voltage rating require specific configuration to optimize the transformer's performance and electrical characteristics. The described winding configuration has two main disadvantages: lower impulse strength and increased labor intensity. Impulse strength refers to the ability of the winding to withstand the transient voltage surges or electrical disturbance. The presence of gaps between the coils and potential weakness in the insulation due to the crossover arrangement may contribute to the lower impulse strength. These require the precise coil positioning. Insulating keys sector installation increases the complexity of the winding assembly, leading to the higher production cost and potentially longer manufacturing times. Continuous Dix winding. As the name suggests, continuous Dix winding consists of multiple flat coils or Dix that are connected in series or parallel. Continuous Dix coils are well suited for high voltage and low large power transformers. The conductor can be wound on the flat side, either as a single strip or multiple strips in parallel. This makes a robust construction for each Dix. Each Dix consists of a number of turns that wound radially, alternating between inside out and outside in, passing uninterruptedly from Dix to Dix. Rectangular strip conductors are typically used and wound on the flat side of the insulating cylinder. This makes each Dix mechanically very strong, as the strips are wound separately along the length. When using multiple strips, the transposition of the conductor is necessary to ensure uniform resistance and inductance. Dix are wound on insulating cylinder with spacers between them, which are arranged vertically to ensure proper oil circulation. In a winding turn with multiple parallel conductors, transposition is used to equalize the current distribution, as in the case of helical winding. Continuous Dix winding are reliable and strong, making them a popular choice for both low voltage and high voltage windings in large transformers. Sandwich windings. Sandwich windings are a type of winding that is commonly used in the shell type transformers. They allow easy control of leakage reactance, which is a measure of how much magnetic flux leaks from the windings. The leakage reactance can be reduced by dividing the low voltage and high voltage winding into a large number of sections or coils, arranging HV and LV section alternatively with the LV section closer to the yoke. The two end low voltage coils have half the number of turns as a normal low voltage coil to balance the MMF of the adjacent sections. Each normal section, whether high voltage or low voltage, carries the same number of ampere turns. The reactance decreases as the degree of voltage subdivision increases. The leakage reactance decreases as the number of section or coil increases. Coil sectionalization not only helps to control leakage reactance but also improve cooling and handling. Drawbacks of sandwich winding. In comparison to concentric winding, they have several drawbacks. They are more labor consuming in manufacture, less stable in respect to short circuits, and are more difficult to insulate from each other and from yoke. This is the reason why the core type transformers with concentric windings are more common.